Welcome to Call Him in Action. My name is Michael Haigh, a technical marketing engineer at Nutanix. Today we're going to be covering Cloud-Init and how we can utilize it to initialize a VM at startup. Let's take a look at how this works. So here I have a blueprint that's just deploying a single Linux service. If we scroll down, we'll see that I have the guest customization box selected. This allows us to specify a Cloud-Init script, or if we're using a Windows VM, we can specify sysprep. So if I maximize this window, we see I'm calling out cloud-config, which is the actual language that's used in Cloud-Init. And then I have a couple sections. The first is a users section where I'm defining information about the CentOS user. The key part here is that I'm adding an instance public key into the authorized host file. This will allow us to SSH into this VM with the matching private key. I'm also adding this user to the sudoers file. And finally, I'm installing a particular software package, LVM2. For a list of everything that you can do with Cloud-Init, there's a great page on Read the Docs that goes through all of these examples. You can even do things like configuring a static IP. So it's a very long page. I'd recommend you going through it to see what suits your needs. Moving back to Calm, let's select a particular application that I've already deployed a couple of moments ago based on the same blueprint. If we select the Simple VM app and go to the Services section, we'll copy this IP. And now we'll see how we can SSH into this VM with the matching private key. I'll specify the private key, specify the username, and then paste in the IP. And we've successfully SSH into this VM. Again, that is made possible by entering in the public key into the authorized host file via Cloud-Init. Thank you for your time today. If you found this video useful, then go ahead and subscribe so you'll be notified when additional content is posted.